Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding Redefining Indian Nationhood, written by Zoya Hassan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is important for sociology, public administration, political science and history optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the episode about Kanaiya that is unfolded in JNU. Now in order to understand this editorial and in order to have a complete idea about the concept of a nation and how this concept of nation differs from patriotism and how this concept of nation differs from the vital concept of liberalism, we need to understand how this concept of nation in itself has evolved. Now, as far as the concept of nation is concerned, in order to understand this, we need to dig deep in the history. And in the history, we need to know about the phase and the period and the era of feudalism. Now from 15th century onwards till 17th century, what we had seen in the entire world, it was a phase of feudalism. There was no concept of nation as such. Now the concept of nation, this concept came into being when the French Revolution actually began to assert itself. Although before French Revolution we had American Revolution that gave the concrete shape of a nation, but the true essence, the true meaning that generally we attached to this word nation, it is something that we owe to the French Revolution. Now, before I tell you about how this concept of nation has evolved, it is important to understand about how the concept of state has evolved. Now, the concept of state is related to a transition that we had seen in the history from the period of feudalism to the period of absolute monarchy. Now, from the absolute monarchies, we've got this concept of state. Now, when these states began to develop themselves as nations, now this is a big question to be answered. Now, the states that were formed because of the absolute monarchies that were established, these states begin to feel different from each other. These states begin to provide the people of a particular region with a particular identity, with a particular feeling, with a particular ethos, with a particular essence. Now this ethos, this feeling, this essence and the feeling of identity belonging to a particular region was wielded together by a concept called culture. Now in a particular region, in a particular geographical space, when the people share their life, when the people share their culture, when the people share their feelings, when the people share their emotions, it gave rise to two things: the materialistic aspect and the non-materialistic aspect. This materialistic and non-materialistic aspect is called as culture. And this culture gives people a feeling that the ones who are belonging to the same creed, the ones who are homogeneous in terms of their ideas, thoughts, habits, dressing sense and the language, they should be treated as a nation. So this feeling, this emotion, this idea of being unique, of being homogeneous. Now, of why being homogeneous? Being homogeneous because of a unique language, because of a unique religion, because of a unique culture, because of a unique way of thinking. Now, this was the reason that this concept of nation came into being. Now, this was the first stage of the concept of the evolution of nation. This was the first stage when people begin to feel that they should be ruled by their own people, because they share the same culture, they are homogeneous in terms of certain things. This is the first stage of the concept of nation. Now, from the first stage of the concept of the nation, there was a movement toward the second stage of the concept of nation. Now, the second stage of the concept of the nation says, not only we are homogeneous, but we are also superior. And we have the right to dominate over the other people. We are not only unique, but we should also be acting in an ascendantic manner. We should also be hegemonizing. We should also be ruling over other people. So this concept of nation actually provokes you. This concept of nation, it actually catalyzes you to be in a kind of a war with the other people. So when you study this concept of nation in detail, you get to know about two things: the concept of identity, and the other is you are trying to hegemonize over the others. Now, how this concept of nation differs from the concept of patriotism? Patriotism just means love for your country, love for what your country is. You're loving the idea of your country, you are loving the religion of your country, you are loving the language of your country, you are loving the flora and the fauna of your country, you are loving the length and the breadth and the heights of your country, you are loving the type of the people that are residing in the country. So this is patriotism. The patriotism will never ask you to fight with somebody, but the concept of nation will ask you to fight with somebody. Now, when this concept of nation was, when it came into being, there was a big question of how this concept of nation should be managed. Should we give freedom? Should we give authority to the people to think freely, or should we not? So this concept of liberalism is actually ingrained in the concept of nation, because a nation is never a static thing. Nation is a kind of organic concept which requires the strengthening of nationalism. And how this nationalism can be strengthened? This nationalism can be strengthened if we will indulge in debate, discussion and discourse. So, keeping into consideration the time limit of this video class, I cannot discuss more about the difference between patriotism, liberalism and nation and the concept of nationalism. So I will be doing it in some other class. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video class your entire civil services preparation. And in order to avail the information of the class that we're offering, please visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainyki.com. And in case you like this video, do click on the like button, do share and comment on this video. And please do install our application. Name of the application is Brainyki. You can find this application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And do install the MCQs application. And the name of that application is IAS MCQs Brainyki. And you can find this from Android platform, that is Google Play Store. This was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.